usually with the second games, a lot of fighting is involved. So, but it looks like hopefully this will be fun and exciting to watch. Sejuani on the map. No skin Rumble. Get reported. GG. No skin Ahri. Team 4 skins, both sides. As we have. Really like. You know, Internum Nocturne was my first skin ever.
I do remember that. I'm pretty sure I missed or gifted it to you.
Yeah, first legendary skin.
I missed who gifted like 4 people that skin. They all got pretty lucky.
Apparently, did you know if you're spectating, there's a health bar in the fountain?
I see it. That's awesome.
Health bar in the fountain.
That is pretty awesome.
Alright, everyone waiting at the gates, ready for the gates to fall here as blue side is ESG, red side, front side gaming. Looks like a simple invade from front side.
Pretty standard start. Both teams sending 5 down to the bot lane, preventing invades again.
Here comes the level 1 Clown Fiest, the gents. Let's see if it happens.
Looks like they're going to rotate in circle. Unless they get caught out here. Let's see what the pings. They don't know where they're at, so...
Dude, don't think they saw them. You're right. They
saw each other, so...
They're just going to go ahead and wrap around.
Almost showed themselves on the blue side tower. That'd have been a little spooky.
Like that Ezreal skin.
Yeah.
Big Final Fantasy fan. So, kind of like a look-alike.
Still 5v5.
Surprise though.
Just gonna get some vision down.
Yeah, it looks like they're gonna try out the wraparound. If they can get a ward down, they're gonna be sad because no one's there.
Like, aw, no one's hiding.
Yep.
Uh-oh, here we go. Are they gonna meet up with each other?
Oh, no.
Are they going to meet up? Boy. The red side versus blue meet up, hiding in the bush. They know. Here comes the
Ahri.
Here comes the threat.
Oh,
they go in. Rumble getting.
Here comes
down.
The Clown Fiesta, ladies and gentlemen.
It looks like they all
that was great.
great
skirmish
blown.
At a minute 38. So that was pretty exciting. That was hype. GG.
Poking
boys.
Each other, tickling each other.
It's packing up,
best
boys.
Best part of the game already. I'm so happy.
Alright, Sander leashing for the Nocturne and of course for the Sejuani.
They're actually taking a lot of damage, already half health.
So, at least no summoners were in there, smart not to blow them. So let's say Cho'Gath versus the Rumble. Let's go boys, let us go.
FS should be pretty good here when it comes to laning phase, seeing that the blue side's Thresh is already half health. He decides to pop some of those biscuits. I think this lane is going to be in favor of red side, just for that little matter.
I think he's going to use his relic shield first to go ahead and get some healing back.
Right.
But kind of just want him to eat a biscuit.
I want him to eat a biscuit.
Yeah.
Toro's favorite snack. Alright, Nami is still not level 2, so I'm assuming Ezreal got the lane first.
Yeah, late the lane to go ahead and release the Sejuani. Very hard.
Don't be taking a lot of to Kaelin. Not a lot. What am I saying? A lot. The biscuits have
Nami, go ahead and use it. Nice. That sends on the
into a
the
combo
Nami.
With no health healing. Ooh. Used by Ezreal. A little nice
pulls
trade.
Out the heal.
Oh, the Ezreal
maybe
goes in.
Thresh.
Pops flash and heal from the blue side.
Exhaust down on the Ezreal.
By Nami to get away from the Q and first
and
blood
there's
goes to
first
the
blood.
support first blood. A lot of minions there. Pretty
whoa,
ooh,
interesting.
All right, don't know about that E flash.
Nami
wait,
getting
executed.
Interesting. No damage procced onto the Nami since Nami flashed away from the Q.
Well, let's look on the top on red side jungle. Nocturne and Sejuani in the general vicinity of each other.
This kind of feels bad. Executed.
they executed so well, but it's just if you hold your summoner's service
going
in with the Ahri, even trade, but the Ahri does have low mana while the Zed pops his health relies. I think that's the only downside with Ahri, since Ahri has to use mana rather than energy can easily be popped up, but with longer cooldowns.
Yeah, I think Zed just traded health potion for lane pressure.
So, fun skirmish bot lane. Got the Ezreal head and the Nami with the first blood kill as well. Early Sightstone, so be able to get that vision down. Nocturne showing his presence topside at the Tribush. So, didn't get anything there. Rumble put a ward down to be able to make sure he doesn't get seen.
I want to note that Caitlyn's the only one with a summoner spell, and it's her flash. So, Nocturne should probably go ahead and gank bot lane while they have summoners down.
It is Nocturne. That is the only thing besides. Sejuani going in for an early invade onto the Raptors as Sejuani takes Raptor camp. Ahri's going to put in vision, still does not see the Sejuani at the Raptor camp.
That's a control ward, so definitely know she's safe taking this Raptor camp.
Exactly. Nocturne about to show up.
Nocturne very low.
Notices that his
could this... And she decides not...
Cho'Gath getting a lot of harassed by the Rumble. Rumble going in, overheated. Will he burn his flash?
Nocturne getting
it.
Flashed on by the Sejuani.
Nocturne at very nothing to health. Still runs away with his life. Zed looking for blood. Even Nami looking for the blood. He's 4 down bot side.
He lived with 9 HP.
Oh, Zed. Zed showed... Oh, and he goes back to base in time. Still 4 bot. Here in the bot lane, Zed and Sejuani.
Oh, yeah,
looks like they're just gonna have to leave since the red side's wave's not shoving. They're put off just counter jungling and leaving.
So Rumble soloing the Cho'Gath. Cho'Gath still has flash. Didn't even burn it. Could have probably survived there, but Rumble also does have flash, so probably could have used it there too.
That's been lag.
Lots of lag. Ping issues. Sejuani
getting
Ahri.
Caught
it looks like
between
they're getting collapsed
people.
Out. No flash by Sejuani charm. Also first kill from Team ESG with the Ahri.
I think Sejuani stayed way too long. Took the Krugs, started roaming into the red side jungle with no vision, no backup.
Usually he would back with the Zed, but it looks like she really wanted to go in to pry of the Nocturne. Nocturne gets an assist there, so an assist is better than none.
A little odd though, since Sejuani could have Arctic Assaulted over the wall to maybe kind of delay them and waste their time, but she decided just to kind of fall where she stood.
I think she had no mana for that, so I'm not sure though.
Let me play it back. She was 4 mana off. She had 1 more second to go.
So she wasn't.
Yeah, she kind of stayed when she had not enough like resources or anything, so
yeah, overstaying on counter jungling will do that.
Kind of interesting to see the Zed inside the enemy jungle deep, not trying to farm lane, but Ahri.
I think
he's
gonna go ahead and
maybe roam top.
Cho'Gath a lot.
Probably roam top because here comes Zed, probably going to ult.
Right, to a control ward. He does have ultimate here, so that's why. Oh, there it is.
There goes Nocturne.
The neck. Free kill, but we got the Nocturne roaming up right to the tribe. I think Zed's gonna take the plant out, mate. What? Okay, there
Nocturne
it is.
Nocturne is not 6 yet, so that is the downside of Nocturne waiting to hit 6. So interesting to see Cho'Gath. Would like to see the Cho'Gath do more. Not really showing a lot of presence.
Looks like he had to pick up that early magic resist on Spectre's Cowl, hoping to not fall in lane again to the to the Rumble and/or Zed. But we'll see how that turns out. Good roam though. I do like to see a Ryze Ding 6, the Zed, he was ready to roam and assist teammates. That's the kind of things you want to see in a quality mid laner, that's for sure.
Assassin 101, so you play Assassin,
Ding 6,
Ding
roam.
6, you roam.
Yep.
Nocturne's going to go ahead and get 6 off of his blue buff whenever he takes it, so probably going to do a little bit more impact with this.
So we have Sejuani roaming bot. She is 6. I guess those jungles helped her a good bit. Those camps. Holds the ult.
Very good flash.
Decides to save it.
Very good flash by Thresh. It's a very smart way to save it. You don't want to really just burn her ultimate. Just
and then
Thresh.
Flash it.
Yeah.
So Sejuani's down bot. Nocturne's gonna go ahead and invade on this red side jungle.
maybe Red's, maybe, yeah, it looks like FS is gonna shove up the lane and maybe rotate to Drake. Or not! We're just gonna...
It looks like Ahri's looking for a rope down, going head to head to the truck push.
They have no vision of it till right at that try.
Went ahead and warmed it up. Zed shoving this wave, but very aggressive, wants to pull Ahri back.
Kinda interesting to see the Cho always shoving the entire game and just taking a lot of harass from the Rumble, but it does have a cowl to be able to prevent a lot of the AP damage. Rumble still hurts, so a lot of missed and Sejuani going in.
Pretty greedy buy up, and it looks like Cho gets getting engaged on. Sejuani of course saves, the Ebola does not want to waste an ult on a free kill.
Lots of shoving by Fridge, and not enough safety, just constantly shoving in the Rumble. He should probably just want to take a step back instead now.
He does have vision, but really with an immobile champion, you gotta play safe.
When you're 0-2 in lane, you just gotta play safe like Kerf says. You can't afford to die in lane and be aggressive on shoving lane.
Miss Charm. I think DSG is probably gonna go ahead and trade his Mount Drake.
They do. I guess they did see the Sojourney topside, so this is a very good decision by Blue Side to go ahead pick up the free Mountain Drake, help them out when it comes to taking objectives in general.
So just like last game, seeing the jungler usually just farming all the way up until 10 minutes, not creating a big impact in the game. Nocturne getting that easy kill with the invade, but not really necessarily a gank. So hopefully we get to see a little bit more off the Nocturne. Surprised he didn't rush cooldown boots to get his ult off a lot faster. And also that Warhammer. Ahri going in, seeing the Sejuani. Doesn't see the Sejuani, actually. Now sees the Sejuani. Going to charm, misses the charm, misses the Q. See. Skill shots are hard, guys. Very hard. But Cho'Gath looks like he wants to look for Sejuani, but not going to get anything there. Has to back off away from...
A lot of damage on this
game. Looking to roam bot lane. He is shooting out some pings, but I think Red Side sees him.
Yeah, definitely got pinged out. Zed waiting on his bush.
Zed looking for blood, maybe?
Off the Yomus, goes ahead and death marks.
Instant ult.
Nice! Spell shield, but it's not enough.
And the Macho picks up a kill off the Nocturne. It's 2-0 Nocturne, a little spooky, guys.
Side of FS is doing the Rift Herald. Haven't really seen a lot of Rift Herald takes.
Honestly, the Rift Herald hasn't been used a lot throughout this entire tournament as they pick up Rift Herald from the Rumble.
Hey, but you know, when you're...
just hard. You have like 8,000 health, really hard to take down, even if you have...
Bot lane's in a fight right now, looks like Thresh is fallen. Another kill for FS.
Equalizer going in by the Rumble with the Cho'Gath. Cho'Gath does a lot of damage and kills the Sejuani as he waits out.
That was a nice ultimate. Does tons of damage, true damage I might add.
Another kill on Igloo. Looks like Igloo, not only Igloo, but Mad Show and Offended just snowballing out of control. No deaths on any of those players, and they have anywhere from 2 to 3 kills. This game looks pretty snowbally, if I must say.
And it looks like they're gonna go ahead and get first turret down bot as well. Probably gonna give it all to Igloo, keep his lead up. 650 straight to him, yep. First brick.
Just the early Mana Moon as well. Surprised he didn't grab a tier as well, tier and then try to build it up, but I guess he's pretty confident in his matchup.
Yeah, he's pretty far ahead. I don't think he stopped.
You know that builds into with the tier, right?
Oh, it does. Yes, I'm so does. Silly. I meant the Sheen. My bad, guys.
He does the tier, and now he picks up the Sheen
into the
Mana
Moon. Okay, there it is. Sorry, guys. I had a moment.
I guess they think they're really that far ahead, and I never really see a Ninja Tabby is usually the main item for Ezreal's because of the massive AD damage from...
Zed has a long sword for each arm and leg. He has 4 of them. I must say he is a little confident there.
Correction, he actually has a total of 8 because of Yomu's.
Jesus, take the wheel. I mean, you can't... He's pretty confident. I mean, how much AD is that? Let's take a look.
40 plus 60 is 100
plus whatever he has. AD
plus
at 13 ult, minutes.
Plus the ult of the Nocturne to be able to get some AD damage too as well. So,
Zed,
ult passive.
OP. See, well, I think what Igloo's doing is just gonna go ahead and rush a ton of CDR so he can start spamming out these ults and mystic shots. And arcane chips.
Ari.
Ooh, very aggressive on the Ari. Misses the charm onto a minion. Gets bubbled. Nice hook.
Nocturne Gages picks up his first kill of the game. Oh, nope. The second assist, excuse me. Then they will drop it. Really good hook after the Nami wave and the Ezreal E. I can't hate on a good hook on a Thresh.
Looks like Igloo just disrespecting the matchup with Nocturne ults and also the skill shots of Thresh.
Zed getting caught out. It's kind of just on this flank.
Match of disengages. It should be fine. No one's chasing.
Oh, lots
Nami
of catches,
getting caught.
Yeah.
Oh, Nami getting caught.
Lots
killing
catches,
spree for the Ari.
Alright, well, take notes, guys. Do not face check with no vision as a Nami into the enemy jungle when you see them rotating down that way. Not the best thing to do.
Zed's not looking for blood. Looks like he's just trying to clear bot lane so Cho'Gath can't reach.
A lot of positioning errors from FS in that last, like, 2 minutes.
2 minutes? Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree on that one. I mean, honestly, there should be no reason why Nezreal gets hooked. He has a 10-second, second flash, if you will. Excuse me, it's a 15-second cooldown on the Arcane Shift. I mean, it's pretty unacceptable.
It gets lower whenever he hits a Q, so...
True.
I think he shifted aggressively into the Ari, trying to get the damage, and then just went ahead and, Spirit Rushed.
Right into him because he knew he had no flash or arcane shift.
Correct.
Yeah, don't blame you. I mean, you're an assassin. You gotta do assassin things.
And then the kid with the follow-up death sentence at the end. That was really beautiful. Right through the minion.
So yep. Really good on Ari, a DPS player to pick up on 3 kills. So and Caitlyn with a 3 assists. Usually Caitlyn can farm, but looks like Caitlyn is behind by 35-36 CS. Hopefully I can pick up some more to be able to start snowballing. Caitlyn is really a snowbally champion, you know, if she has items. Looks like Rumble is still split pushing, trying to get pressure onto that tier 2 tower as Cho'Gath walks up there.
It looks like Nolan's rotating. Looks like he's probably end up getting this tier 2. I mean, you would
He'll
think...
He'll get it eventually.
They knew that they picked up Rift Herald. They know he has it, and I'm surprised they're giving up. Okay, Cho'Gath's roaming up.
Looks like they're going to have to sacrifice. None of them have TP, so they can't really go ahead and engage. Zed looking for blood on the Ahri. Go ahead and ignite. Ult. GG.
Wow, wait. Oh, exhaust. And...
Really interesting duel because Zed is big. So, lethality does hurt as Fire Drake.
Lethality hurts when you don't have armor.
A little early on the smite, but she got it. They picked it up, had a control ward, so blue side Nocturne could not ult in and just steal it away. So good play on the whatever player dropped that.
I really question the Merc treads picked up on Nocturne. Of course there's some CC with the Sejuani and the Nami. And Equalizer going down with the Sedge ult. Caitlyn gone, Ezreal with the pickup.
That's a lot of AoEs.
Can't beat the Wombo, guys. It's only, you know, 17 minutes. They're up roughly 8k. You can't get too cocky on a little, when you're out of place like that, people are going to take advantage of it.
They have plenty of vision, too. They saw him, you know.
Well, they're rolling up, and they saw it.
Honestly, I think it's still a little bit disrespectful not thinking about, of course, front side's damage. But it looks like Cho'Gath getting caught
here. Cho'Gath's probably going to get caught again.
Ezreal does have not a lot of... And our flash didn't probably need to flash there, but I guess flash for safety. To make sure that he's way out as four top as Zed pushes bot lane.
Right. He already has 6 stacks on Cho'Gath. Can't get any more.
Okay, we got the Nocturne ulti. The Zed ulti in the... Oh, 1-for-1.
Can't Still, I think it's a really good trade by the Nocturne for Nocturne being behind.
Oh yeah, 1-for-1 and you get
Trading
a tower.
1-for-1 when you're behind is really good. Especially when you give an assist to the Caitlyn who's already behind. Any kind of gold influx like that is going to be better. But trade on the top lane, tower.
When you're trading a tower and that's all you get is a kill, it's not really worth.
Exactly. Rumble now being the jungler. Rumble in the jungle, picking up the wolves. Trying to clear up. No towers taken by ESG yet. So Wonder if they can be able to make some plays. Rumble getting caught with the Ahri going and ulting Death Sentence. And the kill shot.
I think
down.
He played way too long. Just kind of was like, oh look, awards, like candy.
Hey look, 30 gold. So.
Oh look, I'm dead.
Yeah.
FS almost up 10,000 gold pre 20 minutes. I mean, not much to really say is unless they want a third of the game, it looks pretty...
Here's probably what I would do if I was ESG. You need to go ahead and decide when is a good time to group up, which is probably now, since the red side is probably grouping up a lot more. Cho'Gath has TP, so he has the right to split push, but don't really see the Nocturne being close to the team. Nocturne does have a global ulti, not that big of a global ulti, but still a long range ult. So hopefully we can see more team play with ESG, since I think that'll help a lot.
I mean, when you're behind and you're kind of getting snowballed on, you kind of gotta cut ties when it comes to lanes and hopefully group and outnumber the enemy and hopefully win a team fight. It's the best bet right now.
Yeah, go to see Zed bot lane. Typical Zed. What they do is go ahead and split. Equalizer already coming out. I don't think it's for damage.
It's just for wave clear to go ahead and keep the mid tower safe.
So Johnny's still chasing. I think Sejuani's trying
they're
to
doing a 2-2-1. Looks like they're trying to get, I guess they're trying to pressure every lane.
I think they're,
so hopefully we get a tier 2.
I think they're mainly pressing. Then Flash Death Sentence by the Thresh going in. No box yet with shields. A 3v2 with the Nami ult coming in. Does take Thresh down with the Cho'Gath by himself. Nice bubble by Nami.
And flashes and then
lots
the Cho'Gath falls.
Lots of kills. We didn't see it, but there was a death that happened bot lane.
Ezreal just goes, oh,
Nocturne solo into Zed.
Maybe?
Oh, Nocturne, oh!
Heal comes out.
Nice damage, nice damage from Igloo, that's for sure. He is 6-1 and 2 now. We got his Trinity Force, look, and his, Muramana. It looks like,
incredibly strong. Flashing the mask.
Snowballing too much out of control.
I think the only positive is just Nocturne killed Zed after he already got wrecked by the Zed. But, again, picking these bad fights is literally what's called hurting ESG. Like, you don't need to initially just go in on a Fed tank, especially I'm trying to go for a Death Sentence. Hopefully,
well, especially when your AD has you don't have a one item completed. The only person who has an item completed that will matter is Ahri and the Nocturne, and the Nocturne wasn't even there.
So hopefully we can see some more turtling, I guess. Just be a turtle, farm up. That's the best thing to do right now. Other than that, it looks like pretty one-sided. As Thresh goes in for the wards, no vision. They don't even know that control ward is in there, so... So, about one-sided again. A little bit longer than when it last had. Zed going in on the Caitlyn with his mark. Shadows got the ult off, pop. Let's see if and let's Cho'Gath flash in ults. Gets a stack.
Oh,
I wonder how much damage that does.
Zed was a little greedy there going in on the Caitlyn when Caitlyn probably was not worth 275 gold there for his life when he got shut down.
But I want to point out Cho'Gath is at 7 stacks. He is trying to crawl his way back into this match, trying to become that front line to just be a meat shield for his team. Nice to see that he's, you know, trying to come back from that tough laning phase.
Yeah, if I was...
Cho'Gath's feast, 620...
Assuming that's what he did on Zed.
Well, 650 true damage. On champions alone.
True damage is true damage, cannot block that stuff. Sejuani trying to like force it out, not going in. Nice bubble and fucking shift.
I do, however, want to point out yet again another control. Hopefully.
Nice charm button to be able to disengage and keep him back. It's better that I see that ESG's not trying to fight the enemy right now. It's not needed. I think Caitlyn Caitlyn still needs to farm up. If he has Infinity Edge will probably help a lot better with these matches.
We got the Runin's Hurricane on Caitlyn now. Vest is just...
Well, I think Caitlyn is a disruptive force mostly into the late game, but early game, she gets wrecked by the enemy team. You can't really do much until she farms up and turns to be able to farm up more. It looks like mid tower is probably going to be the first to go down or try to go down. They do have lots of late clear. That is the positive side of ESG. Ezreal taking up that free red buff from ESG.
Rotating towards Baron, looks like they may be trying. And they are! They're going for a 24-minute
The vision's very dark for ESG from the Baron pit. They either have to face check, or
I
just...
I think if I was ESG right now, I'd do not even a blue trinket ready to go into the pit too as well, so... Nice equalizer with the Nami wave with the Ebola from...
Oh.
That's the wombo we've been waiting on, guys.
Yeah, that's a lot of accuracy.
So, pretty...
That's 0-3. Looks like FS came on top not only with the Baron, but 3 kills as well.
Well, I think it was Juani. I think they want to get a clean ace,
really,
so they
nice
go ahead and...
...by the Nomi to catch that fresh, but it looks like, yes, clean. 4 for none, so Juani being the lowest. Ezreal going in, flashing over, very confident slash, very greedy, but gets the kill. So...
They get an assassin, that's cool, I'm 7-1.
Assassinate the assassin. You know, double lifted at the Bjergsen, like, I think yesterday. Ezreal and the Ahri just goes ahead and kills him.
This game's looking like it's coming to an end right here as FS just took top inhibitor, now going for mid inhib.
Depending on how the events play out, probably can't take the next...
I mean, he spilled the Nami bubble right in front of everyone, so you gotta expect a fed Ezreal just gonna come up to you and non-stop just harass you, and he has the red buff. You're not gonna wait for him.
Looks like front side going with the safe win, trying to take all inhibitors, and not trying to force anything. And with the backs too as well, so...
Which is definitely, even though they're doing very well, they're respecting the making sure...
that they're taking care of the lead rather than, of course, taking care of themselves. They have the lead, they know how to use it. 19k gold lead from the front side. Not a lot of turtling, not a lot of vision. I say that a lot because usually turtling can win games. Looks like front side is going ahead and knock on the doors of ESG to be able to go in and try to take over their base. Still lots of wave clear, but not necessarily enough to be able to clear the supers.
Wow, just one E from the Zed drops Nocturne's health a ton.
Nocturne doesn't really have a lot of tank items. Lots of CDR, but not a lot of CDR to really use. As Zed goes in, EQs. W's gets charmed.
Thresh is dead.
A lot of shutdown by Zed going in
shutdown.
Really hard, but Ezreal cleaning up on the Caitlyn team, go ahead.
On the fountain. Equalizer on the fountain as well.
So it looks like that is decided. Cho'Gath.
Igloo picking up a double, picking up the triple. Up.
Gets shot down, sword. Stays on the fountain too long. 1,000 true damage per second. Nothing to laugh at.
Ooh, with a disrespect saying GG easy from the Thresh. I think that was a little troll, but you know.
It looks like Frontside takes the third place match. GG guys. Very fun match to watch. Pretty one-sided. Expected a little bit more, but can't expect it all right.
20,000 gold. FS was that much ahead at 28 minutes. Now, if that's not a snowball, I don't know what is.
So about that game, I was kind of interested about, of course, the picks here. Cho'Gath pick, not really seen a lot, but it happened. Cho'Gath did happen, in this game.
Carries for FS did a really good job. 10-4-3 on the Zed, 10-2-6 on the Ezreal.
Do have Frontside Esports as the win as they pick up the third place in our TBCS, and that'll probably do it, folks. We have the games recorded for the teams to be able to archive them, to go and check on them. Hopefully they can check on the mistakes and improve their gameplay if we start up another tournament. But that'll do it. Thank you for guys that participated. Love to have you guys back again on our next tournament. Make it 10 times better than what it does before. But on that, you guys have a wonderful night, and thank you, Peeves and Vunti, for shoutcasting with me.
No problem, thanks for having us.
Alright, that is it. You guys have a good night. Link, and we will link a description below, tag us, and anything that you see, make highlights, of course, of the game if you saw any. Like us on Twitter, and we are on Twitter, on twitter.com.